In the south of France, there where the River Rhone flows into the sea, is a lonely, almost desert region called the Camargue. Here for more than 1,000 years has lived a herd of wild horses, descendants of those who carried the Vandals westward from the Mongolian plain. A race of exiles, ancient and royal. They tell a story in that silent country about the noblest of these horses and a boy. The name of the horse was White Mane, for his mane was as white as the plume of a hero or the crest of a wave. He was the leader of this herd, a proud and fiery stallion whom all the other horses obeyed. White Mane mistrusted human beings, for their very sight seemed to endanger his freedom. And when he thought it necessary, he knew how to stand up to them. One day, some ranchers decided to capture him. And on that day, the story of White Mane in the world of men began. It was thus in flight that the boy first saw the wild stallion. The name of the boy was Falco. He was the grandson of an old fisherman. Known was liberty, so he didn't take kindly to this trap. He was truly a wild horse. Thank you. Because he had escaped them, the men wanted more than ever to capture White Mane. But now that he had tasted captivity, White Mane was more firmly resolved than ever to stay free.
monsieur, votre chapeau.
Your hat, sir, the boy said. The ranch owner was much too angry even to thank him. The dirty beast, he said. Anyone who wants him can have him as far as I'm concerned. Even me? Falco asked. He could hardly believe his ears.
Oui, même à toi.
Even you, the old man said. But by the time you catch him, your fish will have grown wings. When the men laughed at Falco, they hurt his feelings. But at the same time, he told himself, now if only I can take White Mane, he will be mine. So he set out to try and take him. White Mane away, the herd was easily taken by the men. Hearing their voices, White Mane had to go to them. For as much as he liked the boy, he was a truly wild horse and wanted even more to gallop with the others. ¶¶ The old man was very pleased with himself. I know horses, he said. I told you he'd come back to his herd. Another had taken White Mane's place as the head of the herd. And White Mane didn't like that at all. While White Mane was away, Falco made everything secure for the time when he would take him again. But the wild stallion returned to seek his friend in his pride of victory and to be comforted. They were determined to recapture him in order to prove that man is always the master. Thank you.
Va-t'en. Pousse-toi de là.
I know how to get him out of there, the old man said. I know what frightens a horse more than anything else. Brave as he was, White Mane was terrified. Yet he might rather have died there in the fire than give himself up through his fear. He's crazy, the old man cried. He's gone plain crazy, that young'un. Straight for the river. The river will stop him. back, the men cried. Come back. The current will sweep you out to sea. We'll give you the horse. We promise. Only come back. He no longer listened to them, for they had lied to him before. And astride White Mane, he vanished among the waves. They swam straight ahead, and the white stallion, who was endowed with a great force, carried his friend towards a wonderful land where animals and men are always friends and forever free.